Every electronics hobbyist who designs custom PCBs will at some point encounter a problem of having parts with no symbol and footprint libraries available online. Creating my own symbols and footprints for components was something that I was avoiding for way too long. I've spent so much time trying to find even the most low-quality libraries for some parts, while I could have created my own in fraction of that time. Don't be afraid of creating custom part libraries for KiCad. It's not hard at all. In this video I will show simple process of creating footprint and symbol for a part. But first, couple of words about the sponsor of this video, PCBWAY.com. When you have designed your own PCBs, you can order them from PCBWAY.com for as low as $5 for 10 pieces of 10x10cm PCBs. Here are samples of some, but not all of the different color options you can choose from. If your project requires more advanced PCBs, 3D printed parts, or CNC milled parts, those are available from PCBWAY.com as well. For all your prototyping and low-volume production needs, go check out PCBWAY.com for up-to-date information on their offering. And also, check out Shared Projects and Module Store section of their website. When you start KiCad, first thing you'll see are these tools. When creating libraries for a new part, Symbol Editor is used to create the schematic symbol which defines the functional or electrical connections. Footprint Editor is used for the footprint that defines physical shape, pin positions, etc. In KiCad, the symbol and footprint of the part are kept in separate files. You can create either both, schematic symbol and footprint, or you can create just one if the other one matches already existing part. There are multiple reasons why this can be a good way. You can design the schematic before deciding which package will be used, and you can also use single footprint for all the parts in the same package type, and you can then update one footprint and changes will affect all of the parts. In this video I will use this motion sensor module as an example. I will design simple symbol and footprint that will be good enough for hobbyist own use. For a complete list of conventions that are required for a contribution to official KiCad libraries, you can check the link in the description. And like that website states, they are guidelines, not rules. If you are creating libraries for your personal use, many of these conventions can be skipped for simplicity. But keep in mind, there's a reason for each of these conventions, and it can be worth the hassle to follow them. But anyway, let's start by creating a new symbol using Symbol Editor. I try not to add my own parts to existing libraries, but create my own. Similar components should be grouped into same library, but for this kind of module, I usually create own library file for it using File, New Library. This library file won't have any other parts, so I will call it RCWL0516. I'll create a symbol inside that library. Usually the library name is made of more generic terms, and this symbol name will be the exact part name. But in my case, I will call both of them RCWL0516. The default reference designator depends on the part. For example, resistors use R, capacitors C, integrated circuits U. I usually use the U for modules as well. It doesn't really break anything if you select wrong designator. Number of units per package is used with components like operational amplifiers, logic gates, etc. When one package can have multiple instances of the same circuit. But most other parts have only one unit per package. Okay, now this symbol has only the designator U. First logical thing to add are the pins. There is this add pin tool, or hotkey P. Most important fields to fill are name, so you know in the schematic what the pin does, and the pin number, so KiCad knows which physical pin that schematic pin is connected to. Proper electrical type can be selected to clarify things and help error checking process, but leaving it unchanged or selecting a wrong one doesn't stop the circuit from working. I will name the pins using text on the PCB and in ascending order starting from this pin. In the KiCad library conventions, it is recommended to put the pins on specific sides based on their function. Inputs on the left side, outputs on the right, power and ground on top and bottom. Again, we don't need to follow those conventions when designing for our own use. Sometimes I like to make the schematic simple to resemble the actual part. Like in this case, I will add pins on the same order as on the module, and I will draw rectangle that has same shape as the module. Additional text or graphics can be added to clarify things in the schematic. Now this symbol should be ready to be used. It's that simple, few pins and a rectangle to wrap things together. Next I will go to footprint editor and create a footprint for this module. Same way as in symbol editor, I will create the footprint library and then the footprint for this part. While the schematic symbol has pins, equivalent items in footprint are the pads. Before adding pads, I will set the default pad properties. The most important things are the hole diameter and pad diameter. 0.9mm is quite common hole size for components, but this really depends on the component. When you divide the difference of pad diameter and hole diameter by 2, you'll get the width of the copper on each side of the hole. This affects, for example, solderability and the clearance between the pads. Again, proper value depends on the component, but hole diameter plus 0.7-0.8mm is something that has worked for me in the most cases. Then the pads can be placed using Add a Pad tool. They will be numbered in ascending order starting from 1, and I know the pads are 2.54mm apart from each other, so I will change the grid to 2.54mm. That way the pads should be placed one step away from each other, like that. This is actually everything that KiCad needs to know. Everything else is for helping designing process and assembling process. I will draw component outline in front silkscreen layer, which is the silkscreen that gets printed on the board when PCBWAY creates the PCBs. I will also draw similar outline in front fab layer, which is documentation for assembly process. It has simple graphics to help the placing of the components. I have measured that the pin 1 is 1.25mm from the left edge of the PCB and 3.5mm from the top edge. I will use finer grid to allow more precise placement of the drawings. I will move the cursor to center of the pin 1 and press space. That zeroes the delta X and delta Y in bottom bar. I can then move the cursor and find the spot where delta X is negative 1.25 and delta Y is negative 3.5. This is the top left corner of the PCB. I'll start drawing rectangle from that point and move the cursor where X matches the width of the board and Y matches the height of the board. I will then copy the shape with Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. Then I will double-click the copied shape and change the layer to front fab. I could draw some shapes to show where the parts like antenna and stuff like that are, but I'll keep this simple and leave those out. This is about creating a simple footprint and symbols, not about creating perfect pieces of engineering design work. But what I will add is the shape on the front courtyard layer, which tells KiCad to not allow other components inside that area. I think I could get away by drawing the courtyard only where the pin header is, as there's room under the module when it is mounted on the PCB. But to not cause any interference or other problems, I will include the whole module's outline inside the courtyard. This should be ready for now. There's lots to improve, but this should be enough to use this in a project. I will save this file and open the symbol in symbol editor once more. I will edit the symbol properties in File, Symbol Properties, and select the default footprint to be the one I just created. This way I don't need to select the footprint every time I place this symbol in schematics. So if I now go to Schematic Editor, place this new symbol in there, then press F8 to update the PCB layout from this schematic, the correct footprint should be automatically added in the layout editor. Just like that. This took some time, as I was explaining the steps while doing it, but usually this would have taken just a couple of minutes. Don't be afraid of creating footprints and symbols in KiCad. It's actually really easy and rewarding. See you next video. Thanks.